All right, reports of North Korea now. Nuclear threats out of North Korea targeting the U.S., saying it has placed long-range missiles into combat mode aimed at numerous Western targets. Ambassador John Bolton, former U.S. ambassador to the U.N., Fox News contributor with me now. And, sir, good morning to you. More words or more than that?
Well, I think the threat to use missiles against targets in the United States like Alaska, Hawaii, or bases like in Guam or Okinawa is probably remote as of this moment. But make no mistake, the North Koreans are getting closer to making those threats a reality, and their ability to hit closer targets in Japan or South Korea can't be dismissed. I think the most immediate concern is that with all this belligerent talk, there is a risk of North Korea taking some provocative action, sinking a South Korean ship as they did a little over a year ago, or doing something that could get us very quickly into a larger confrontation. This is a very dangerous regime. It is not rational in our terms. And even though their more extravagant threats are not realistic, you have to take this kind of thing seriously.
Let me pick up on the point you make, because they have threatened in the past and they have acted on those threats, especially when it comes to their South Korean neighbor down here across the 38th parallel, Japan off to the east. But specifically for Western targets, American targets, they've talked about Guam, they've talked about Hawaii, they've talked about certain Western American cities that we can show you on the map here in just a moment once it pulls up here. You know, whether you apply truth to this or not, Mr. Ambassador, it is fair to say that they cannot take a nuclear warhead and put it on a rocket. But they can take a long-range rocket and perhaps, you know, aim at Anchorage or Seattle, or more likely out here, Honolulu, Hawaii, or Guam. Is that the more likely scenario when it comes to the United States?
Well, I think that is possible now. Now, people say, well, why would they do anything so foolish? The United States would retaliate overwhelmingly. It would be a disastrous mistake for South Korea to do it. That's only if you think North Korea's leadership is just as rational as we are. It's called mirror imaging. It's a real problem at the State Department. You're a reasonable guy. You think the people on the other side of the negotiating table are reasonable? Not necessarily. And it's the kind of Hitler in the bunker mentality that has pervaded the North Korean leadership's thinking over the years that really should worry us. It shows why the continuation of the regime itself in North Korea is a problem that we need to be addressing really just as much as the nuclear capability.
We've addressed this too just in the past 10 days or so. I mean, this is a long-range missile animation here behind us here from North Korea. If that were to launch, we have just taken more anti-missile batteries and moved them now to the West Coast. Initially, they had been planned. They were canceled by the current administration, and now they have reversed course. Would that serve logic in order to prevent a possible hit on the western part of the U.S.?
Well, I think we should have done it. We should have deployed these missiles in 2009 when they were originally scheduled. And although there was great fanfare for that announcement, they won't actually be deployed until 2017. But it's intended to protect innocent American populations against this kind of threat from rogue states. It's why we need a much more robust national missile defense capability than the Obama administration's planning. And we need, as our military has done, overflying North Korea recently, to have the capability to respond, to try to deter this irrational regime. But it's not a place we should want to be. I think our objective here should be the elimination of the North Korean regime, the peaceful reunification of the peninsula. We've said that's our policy since 1945. We need to act on it.
One more point here. They shelled an island 3 years ago, killed four people. They're responsible for killing 46 sailors when they sank a South Korean naval ship. But back to your first answer, you believe that action is more likely, if any, at this time?
Yeah, in both those cases, the South Korean government, even though it was under a relatively conservative president at the time, took no retaliatory action. Opinion in South Korea was very negative on the lack of retaliation. So you've got a newly elected president in South Korea now. If there's another incident like that, killing South Korean military personnel or civilians, I think the pressure for retaliation would be high. And that's how a miscalculation on North Korea's part could get us into something very, very serious with American troops there on the peninsula.
Thank you, sir. John Bolton, Mr. Ambassador from Washington.
The North Korean video shows the White House in the crosshairs, the U.S. Capitol blowing up. The latest messages posted by the North Korean government online, a further sign of what the U.S. worries is an increasingly unpredictable Kim Jong-un, the North Korean leader who threatens war with the United States and South Korea. On CNN's The Lead, the president's chief of staff told Jake Tapper the U.S. will be ready for any provocation.
Obviously, the kind of antics and the kind of language that we've heard from them, to include what you've just shown on your show here, are the kinds of actions that don't connote strength, but rather connote some kind of weakness and frankly, outlandish behavior.
Even before this video, the U.S. intelligence community had a grim outlook.
The rhetoric, while it is propaganda-laced, is also an indicator of their attitude and perhaps their intent. So for my part, I am very concerned about what they might do.
The latest video is full of images of the North Korean military. The announcer says the fuse of nuclear war is slowly burning.
The fuse of nuclear war is slowly burning.
And that there will be, quote, no warning of North Korean plans.
The sheer threat that they would openly threaten a nuclear attack against the United States is problem enough. But their military movements along the DMZ, the demilitarized zone in North Korea, a whole new set of problems for us.
The White House is taking all of this very seriously because the U.S. cannot predict if and when threats might become a military confrontation.
So you have a 28-year-old leader who is trying to prove himself to the military, and the military eager to have a sable rattling for their own self-interest. And the combination of that is proving to be very, very deadly.
만일 미국이 무모한 도발을 걸어온다면 우리 혁명 무력은 즉시 선멸적인 타격을 가할 것이며 전면 전쟁에는 전면 전쟁으로 핵 전쟁에는 우리 시기 핵 타격전으로 대응할 것입니다.